Hello and welcome to the Gastric Health Show. My name is Dawn Boxall and I am your host today. And we are talking about the topic of resistant starch and why it is beneficial to patients who have had weight loss surgery. And really just any person who, any human being can benefit from this. But I'm specifically relating it to weight loss surgery patients today. So, resistant starch is really just a food item that is starchy that is not able to be digested or broken down in the small intestines. And then, when it gets to the colon, then it can ferment and actually can turn into a prebiotic, which can help grow your good bacteria. And it can also help stabilize your blood sugars. There's studies showing that it can decrease your hemoglobin A1C and decrease inflammation. There's lots of health benefits to prebiotics. So many weight loss surgery patients have the understanding that it is a bad thing to have carbs, and carbs are the enemy. And some of that is true, but I am going to put a little twist to it and show you that not all starches are bad, and that they're actually good to include in your diet regularly. So, the resistant starch that can be beneficial to you, we're not talking about the refined grains, so we don't want enriched flours, we don't want enriched flours made into pastas and noodles, we don't want, you know, any crackers, and any of those are not what I'm talking about. Those do not have resistant starch that is going to benefit you. The resistant starch can be things like potatoes, it can be leeks, Jerusalem artichokes, onions, garlic. Those are all kind of things that can turn into a positive in your colon that will help balance out your microbiome, help balance out your blood sugars, and be a benefit and not a negative to you. So that's a little different than most of you think. Because most weight loss surgery patients know that they typically need to cut down on the carbs. And I agree 100%. If you are eating a lot of packaged processed foods, you definitely need to cut those out. Not a fan of any of those. I am into real whole foods, and that's where I want you to not be afraid to add in some friendly starches like a white potato or red skin potatoes, because they do have benefits to your health in ways that really, until recently, no one really understood. Until they started diving into the microbiome, they really didn't understand the benefits of some of these things. So that whole anything white, don't eat it because it's going to raise your blood sugars because of the glycemic index. Some of that is, part of it is true, but I'm going to show you the twist of what makes that not true. So, an example, white potatoes. So we have just russet potatoes. I have 4 russet potatoes that I boiled, and then I chilled in the refrigerator and put a little salt and pepper on, but the chilling is what changes the whole thing. So when you have a starch that you, when you, like the potato starch, when you boil that, the starch molecules, if you want to think of them like a ball of yarn, the heat unravels the yarn, and then when you chill it, it makes it go back into that ball of yarn, but it's even more tighter and more compact, that it's even going to be more resistant to being able to be digested where in the small intestine where food is digested. So if you had these russet potatoes and you heated them back up again, you lose that benefit. So it is truly only when it is chilled. Same thing for white rice. The basmati white rice is your best pick if you're going to have rice. So I know a lot of weight loss surgery patients don't tolerate rice in general, but if you do, that would be how you would want to eat it. Chilled, not warm. So probably not a typical way that a lot of Americans eat rice, but keep that in mind. It can be room temperature, and that would be adequate. It is just the heat, when you heat it up, that's when those starch molecules really unravel and they lose their resistant starch benefits. So remember, when you have those starches, they need to be chilled. So the white potatoes are one thing that we have, and then we also, I have some celery, some onions, I did some eggs to add some protein, some carrots, and we did some jalapenos to give it a little kick. And I have the expeller pressed oil mayonnaise with some Dijon mustard and some apple cider vinegar, kind of all mixed together to tie it all together. And so basically, when you add all these ingredients to the chilled potatoes, just keep it in the refrigerator and you are good to go. And you will be set for a fabulous side dish to take to someplace that you can feel confident that you are going to benefit other people's health as well as your own and not feel guilty. Or if you're out and have that choice between a baked potato or mashed potatoes or a potato salad, always pick the potato salad and it will benefit you for years to come. So I'm just gonna add in these colorful veggies, and that was kind of my goal with this, was to add as many colors as I could. I did a half an onion, I did one carrot, I did three eggs. I'm not sure I'm gonna add all of them. Maybe a couple, and then one pretty big jalapeno, so I'm just gonna add a little bit in there. And then the mayonnaise was half a cup of mayonnaise, but a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar and 2 tablespoons of the Dijon mustard, and just kind of mix it all together, and you will have a great side dish to add that will boost your beneficial bacteria with the prebiotics. It will also balance your blood sugars and help stabilize that hemoglobin A1C so that you don't have any issues with your blood sugars in the future, as well as decrease the inflammation and things that contribute to it from the other starches. This starch will not. So I hope I have given you something new to talk about, something new to think about, and feel free to read any of the articles that I attach. Feel free to comment and ask any questions on this resistant starch and as a prebiotic and a blood sugar stabilizer. So I hope you guys have enjoyed today's show, and thanks for visiting. Bye.